Hello everyone, Fancy here, you're watching Fantavision, and today I'm discussing a couple different things that I thought were interesting in the news of gaming. And the first topic is the delay of Cyberpunk 2077. Now, quite a lot of people are upset about this delay, but I'm actually kind of glad about it, because I don't know about you, but I'm tired of games launching in a broken, terrible state. I want my game to work on day one, and I don't want my experience ruined just because I'm an early adopter. I feel like people that have bought games nowadays at launch have been punished way more for supporting these companies than the people that wait for like the game to be $20, which is what I've tend to do recently because of that exact reason. Not only do games drop super quickly in price, but the fact that the quality of the games at launch is worse for more money than it is later when it's cheaper just doesn't make any sense to buy it in these broken states for $60. So the fact that they're pushing this game back another 5 months means they're going to put the time and effort into making a complete and working product. And as we've seen with The Witcher 3, CD Projekt Red, just they know what they're doing. Now, this news is a little bit bittersweet, not because of the delay. Like I said, I don't mind that. Lots of great games coming out between then and now. I don't quite have that issue with a lot of people where they're like, oh, it's a gaming drought, I can't wait for things. No, I have a massive backlog of games, and I'm sure most people do if they really think about it. So I've got plenty to play. There's The Last of Us 2 coming out between then and now. Animal Crossing. I mean, there's so many amazing titles I don't have off the top of my head, but there's going to be plenty of games to play before that game comes out. So I can wait. But unfortunately, and now I would happily wait longer, but CD Projekt Red does not want to wait longer because they obviously need to make money, and because of that comes the cost of crunch time. Now, crunch time is a topic that was brought up quite a while ago during the Fortnite and a couple of other games that were experiencing crunch time. Oh, Anthem was one of them. Where it's this thing in the games industry that developers are just supposed to work all the time. And they're supposed to go eating into their free time. They're supposed to eat into their weekends. They're supposed to basically work themselves until just pure exhaustion. People passing out at desks. People not having time for their families. I mean, this is ridiculous. This is a video game. I can wait. I don't know about you guys, but if it meant that these people could live a normal life and not be completely miserable, I can wait. I think it's worth waiting for. So the fact that crunch time is happening again at CD Projekt Red, it puts that little bit of a stain on an otherwise spotless company in my book. I mean, CD Projekt Red has done so many things correct with not only their game presentations, but the way they launch their games in a working state. They take their time and they just include it with so many extras and goodies. And when they release expansion pack DLC stuff, it's not just DLC stuff. It is a full-fledged expansion pack like the good old days when you went out and bought a boxed expansion, and that expansion was just almost another game in itself, and that's what they did. And I'm sure that Cyberpunk 2077 is going to be just as finely crafted as The Witcher 3, if not more so, hopefully more so. But it is a shame that unfortunately these developers will have to suffer. And there's that whole debate on crunch time. Some people for some reason defend it. If you're not a corporate bootlicker, I don't get why you would. They're not looking out for the welfare of the developers, they're looking out for the welfare of the bottom line. And that is unfortunately the reality we live in, that most companies will do that to salaried employees. The other bit of news kind of, gave me a little bit of a chuckle, and that's Ubisoft wants to start making their games more unique. And that's because I guess The Division 2 didn't sell too well, even though I thought it did, but apparently not well enough. What we all know their standards. I mean, Call of Duty regularly sells like a bajillion copies and they go, what a disappointment. So now I do see that a lot of games have not been doing as well. I mean, I know Ghost Recon Breakpoint came out, flopped, and then was $20 immediately in the bargain bin because it was a broken, shambling game of, it was nothing. It was a dead game at launch. And unfortunately, The Ghost Recon series is kind of dead. And most of their series, if you really think about it, are dead. Now, you can go, well, Phantom, Assassin's Creed, Far Cry, they're still fun games. The problem is, none of the games that they make anymore, even Rainbow Six is a completely different beast, but it doesn't really fit in this category. But their three, I forgot about, what's the Watch Dogs? I forgot about Watch Dogs. That's even part of it too. Okay, so I was gonna make a whole video about this. I still might in the future, but Far Cry, Assassin's Creed, Ghost Recon, they all started as something unique and different and have now just kind of homogenized and they just became the same game. So Assassin's Creed started as this really interesting new idea of being an assassin, and you go on an adventure, and there's this stupid sci-fi part of the story that nobody really likes, but overall, it was a really fun game. You're exploring, there's a little bit of side crap that's not that big of a deal, and it just got better and better and better until we hit Odyssey, which then, I mean, they had to at this point do something, but unfortunately, it became what everything else is. It is now an open world action RPG game. That's what it is. There's a leveling system, there's grindy stuff to it, there's just countless pointless things to do, countless pointless things in the map, collectibles out the ass. There you go. Far Cry. Interesting idea. It's a shooter. You're going to this crazy island. There's like mutations and there's like creepy stuff in the jungle and you don't know what's going on. There's a mystery. Second one. Oh man, you're in Africa and you have to worry about malaria and the fire like catches like, you can have like a whole forest fire type thing, but it's not the forest because it's in the desert, but you can have like a whole brush fire happen and you've got all these crazy realistic things going on. And then three, it's a open world action shooter RPG game with a bunch of pointless collectible things on the map. And four, same thing. Five, same thing. And New Dawn. I almost forgot about New Dawn. I think everybody did. Now, Ghost Recon. Ghost Recon started as a squad-based third-person shooter. It was quite a lot of fun. It kept getting, you know, progressively better, and then it kind of got a little weird, and then it became Wildlands, which is an open-world action shooter RPG game with a bunch of pointless things on the map that you can collect. You're noticing the trend here. That's the trend that they're trying to get rid of because this formula has been working for them. But I'm thinking all the sales across the board are starting to dip because people are sick and tired of buying the same game over and over and over. Jim Sterling put it best when he said Ubisoft games are like junk food now. They're not bad, but it's just filler till the next real meal of a game comes out. And that's exactly what they don't want anymore. They want to be the meal again, and that's great, but I don't know if I really trust them because the monetization in Rainbow Six Siege, for some reason, nobody's talking about just how god-awful it is. Let me break this down. I broke this down in the podcast, but I need to break this down again because you really need to just think about how bad this is. So you buy the game, okay, and you start off with a couple operators, whatever. Then if you want more of the operators, you have to get the season pass, and there's a new season pass every year. And then there's, if you want cosmetics, you gotta buy the cosmetics, and then you can buy the individual ones, but there's also the packs, so there's still loot boxes. Oh, and by the way, there's a battle pass now. So there's like five ways that this game has been monetized. Do you really need to monetize a game that freaking much? No, you don't. You really don't. You're making enough money with one of those things. You don't need all of the monetization things. I feel like at this point, Rainbow Six Siege should just be free, and then there you go. You've got all those other things, but even then, that's too much. Even as a free-to-play game, I still think it's over-monetized. So as a game that you have to pay to get into, it's ridiculous. So even though they're telling us, hey, we want to make games unique again. We want to make them actually different experiences because The Division 2 is also an action shooter RPG game with a bunch of pointless stuff on the map that you can collect. And Watch Dogs 2. Actually, you know, there's a lot of stuff that's good in it, but it's still an action shooter RPG with a bunch of shit to collect. So, every single Ubisoft game except for Siege is the same exact thing. And I'm happy they want to start making unique games again, but Rainbow Six Siege's monetization has me worried. And I mean, Assassin's Creed monetization has me worried. All of their monetization has me worried because it means even if they come out with new unique games, they're still going to be filled with time savers and other stupid ass microtransactions. So let me know what you guys think about all this news down below in the comments. If you think Ubisoft will actually start bringing some originality to the table, or if you think they're just creatively bankrupt. And let me know what you think about this delay with Cyberpunk 2077. If you think it's as good of a thing as I do, or if you're like, I'm done waiting, I want the game now. So thanks for watching, everyone. If you guys liked the video, please like it, subscribe for more content, and as always, have a fantastic day. See you guys.